Welcome to this video. In this video, we're gonna learn how to group tables in SSRS. We're gonna learn how to create a parent group, how to add a subtotal, and then how to sort groups. So let's get started. I have my report here set up, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run the report, and I'm gonna show you the scenario over here. So I have this report, and it's running by the list of the employees. What I want is I want to run by the department of the employees rather than the list of the employees. So I want to see how many employees are based on each particular department. So let's get to it. What I want to do is I'm going to change my view to design, and I'm going to ensure that my grouping is visible on my report. Once it is visible, I'll go on the details tab. I'm going to right click on it, and I'm going to add a parent group. Now, once I add a parent group, it will ask me how do I want to group this table X. I'm going to select department because that is how I want to group this table. Now, I also have the option to add a group header and a footer. I will show you this one example just to show you what happens when I select these two options. So I'm going to click on those and click on OK. Now, if I just run the report as it is, you notice that it has actually done the grouping for me, but it has a header, and at the bottom, it also has a footer as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back to our design. So I can keep a header on top of the group header, or what I could do is I could remove this department and put it on top of it. So just to give you an idea of what I mean is, if I select department over here, and what I could do is I could delete this column. So if I delete this column, that column will be deleted, and the department will now appear on top, but it will appear on that particular column. So in order to have it appearing in all the columns, I would select that. I will hold the control button on my keyboard, and I'm just going to press this columns, and I'm going to click on merge over here, and it'll get merged. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to run this report, and then you'll see that the department is now grouped on top. So if I scroll down, you'll see now it's grouping it by that field that I have selected. So you could group it either on top or on the left hand side. In this example, I'm just going to show you how to do it on the left hand side, but you could use it however you prefer. So what happens if you don't want this top row to be shown? And what you can do is you can just highlight that, right click on it and select delete row. What it's going to do is it's going to delete the top row that is within the group. However, we're going to keep on the footer of the group, as we're going to use this to calculate the totals. So let's get into that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to remove this last column department, because now it's grouped on the first column. So I don't need this. I can go ahead and delete that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my totals maybe at the end over here, and I'm going to hover my mouse over here so that it'll show me the field, and I'm going to select employee code. This is the count that I want the system to do, and what I'm going to do is double click on it, right click on it, and select summarize by and select count. So what it'll do is it will do me a count inside that particular group that I have done. And then what I want to do is I want to add a field over here as total, and I want to match this together. So I can highlight it by holding and dragging my mouse, or I can click on control and click on this, and then I'm going to click on merge. I can bold this in a different color. I'm just going to do that as well. Just do some basic quick editing over here, and now I'm going to run the report. If I scroll down, you'll see that the total is now showing inside each group. Now, what happens if I want to add an overall total as well? Let's do that quickly as well. So if you're gonna go back to your design, just click on the table so that you can see the gray lines over here. Go to the last one, highlight the last row, and right click on it and select insert row outside and below. Now what you can do is you could add an again, right click, summarize, and do a count. And over here, you would have to hold your mouse and drag it, merge it, and write total employees. And now let's run the report. So if you run the report, you'll see that the total is speaking fine. But if I go to the last page of this report, you'll see that there's a total summary of that employees that is showing over here. One thing you notice is if I have this row count from a previous session of the class, and so if I don't want to have this column, if I want to delete this column, if I go back and if I highlight and try to delete this column, you'll see that the merged data also gets highlighted because it is merged. Now, if you want to delete a column, you would need to split this, click on split, so it will unmerge it. If you click on this again, it will unmerge it, and then you can go ahead and delete this. Now, if you delete this, if since you wrote it over there, that will also get deleted. So you can go ahead and write the same thing on this field, and you can do that over here as well. And again, you will have to apply the same steps in terms of merging the data, and your data is now merged. If you want to run and check how the data comes out, you click on run and your data is all good. Next, what we want to do is we want to apply some sortings on this group. Now, in the previous session, I showed you how to apply sortings. You can click on the table, right click on the top line, grid line over here, and select tableX properties and go to sortings, and you can apply sortings. That is applicable if you do not have any grouped data, then you can go ahead and apply sortings within that. Once you group our data, your sorting would be control within the group properties of it. So to show you that, you would cancel that out. You go to the row groups over here. By default, your parent group over here is department. Now if you right click and you go to the group properties and click on sorting, you will see that there's a sorting applied inside that particular group, and by default it's going by the department. So over here you can change if you want to sort the group in some other order. However, if I click on OK, if this is fine, but I want to control the sorting of the details over here, then what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the details group over here and select the group properties. Once I do that, I can go to the sorting tab over here, and now I can add. So if I click on it and select gender for this matter, if I select OK and if I run this, you will now see that the data is sorted by the department in alphabetical order, and it is now running the data in the order of the gender first. Now it's male, and now it's showing you the total. So there you go, guys. I hope you have liked this video. If so, please give a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. Here are some of the other videos that you might want to watch.